Dante's Boxer Nation, Dante's Cooking Nation. We are out here. Where are we at?
We're out here in Bangkok.
There you go. She's from Ireland. Matter of fact, introduce yourself to the world.
My name is Hannah, and I'm from Ireland, and I'm the biggest fan of cooking show.
You hear that?
Yeah.
The biggest fan.
And I'm from Ireland. Sorry.
No, I can edit it. Don't worry about it. All the way in Bangkok, Thailand, y'all.
No, I'm getting in right. Ireland as well.
In Ireland. You hear that? DBN is international, guys. Dante's Boxer Nation, what's going on, guys? So, in a fight that a lot of people expected to be a foregone conclusion, an easy fight for Gilberto Ramirez turned out to be a complete straight-out war against Unieski Gonzalez. A fight that looked like it was pretty much going to be over with around the fourth round, end up going all the way to the 10th round, where Gilberto, he finally got Unieski Gonzalez out of there. It was a little reminiscent of the Tyson Fury-Deontay Wilder fight, because just like Deontay Wilder, Unieski, he looked like he was out on his feet around the fourth round, but yet he managed to make it a war all the way to the 10th round. Now, don't get me wrong, Gilberto was clearly winning the fight. He was just getting caught with more punches than he should have gotten caught with. But I will say, with Gilberto Ramirez's lack of defense, he makes up for a lot of it with his offense, with his unique style or his unique combination, because he's a very tall, long, light heavyweight, but at the same time, he can fight on the inside and he can throw punches in bunches. He'll go to war with you. So he's kind of like your typical aggressive fighter, where he starts off slow, and then after a couple rounds, he kicks it into overdrive and he starts to break his opponents down with the accumulation. This would be another fighter on that long list of real fights for Canelo Alvarez when it comes to Gilberto Ramirez. Now you have Gilberto Ramirez, Bivol, Better Biev, Joe Smith, Anthony Yard, all at the light heavyweight division. Then you have David Benavidez and David Morrell at 168. So the question is, where does Canelo Alvarez go from here? Will he take a real fight? We'll see. Gilberto Ramirez is no joke. Gilberto, he's been calling out Bivol. Now that would be a huge fight at 175 if the fight can be made. With that being said, I'm gonna go ahead and wrap this video.